After Zhang Daqian, a leading modern proponent of traditional Chinese painting, traveled around the world and visited countless scenic spots, he finally settled in this house, not far from the National Palace Museum. This house was designed and built by Zhang Daqian, who identified the location and named it the Abode of Illusions.
基本上一进来的时候是前厅，进来以后呢是有一个小的玄关，很特别是进来的前面的两间，左手边是大会客室，然后右手边是餐厅。那很明显的可以看得出来，当时大先生盖摩耶金舍的时候，其实摩耶金舍就是一个他很重要的这个社交的一个基地，他跟这个文人雅士接触交流的一个地方。
The Abode of Illusions incorporates the landscape in everyday life, and from the feel of mountains and streams, realizes the meaning of life.
张大千就中国山水画家会整理园子，那种什么的植物是他喜欢的啊，梅花啦、茶花啦啊，他不同的品种。那他在院子中散步的时候，他就看着他的植物，他就开始，我们最怕就开始比，这手一这样子比，完了完了，这棵植物又要开始搬了。那可是张大千在移动这些，都是在造景，所以是他设计的前面的样子。
泼墨，可以讲呢，是大千先生在他个人创作生涯过程当中经历、研究所产生出来的艺术的表现。在这个泼墨的过程当中，他会根据这个墨汁的这个痕迹，去模想，他过去山水当中的精彩的。 这样的画面，跟这个不定型的墨汁结合，所以对我而言，张大千的泼墨不但是把传统的山水跟当代的自由开放的造型结合在一起，而且呢，它当然毫无疑问，在我们华人水墨世界当中，可以讲说是达到一个重要的巅峰。
Zhang Daqian passed away from a heart attack on April 20th, 1983. In accordance with his will, Zhang's family members donated his residence and paintings to the National Palace Museum.
When we set up the memorial museum, the intention is to preserve Da Qian's life.
例如说，像大会客室呢，有两套完整的沙发，柜子里面也有一些奇石，是他珍贵的收藏。摩耶金舍除了开放给民众做参观之外，故宫也把他的作品定期的安插在平常的展览当中。 算是向这位世纪的大师致敬。Zhang
Daqian played an essential role in Taiwan's art history, as well as in the history of Oriental art. He's the most prodigious ink and wash painting artist of the 20th century. Despite the fact that Zhang Daqian has gone, his spirit is present in this house. Waiting for visitors to arrive.